They're a modern-day Stone Age Toastmasters club. From the town of Tampa, they're a page right out of his story. When I call you to the podium to answer an impromptu table topics question, you will come here through the courtesy of your own 2 feet. When you answer my question, we'll have a yebba-debba-doo time, a debba-doo time. We'll have a gay old time. And do not forget to work the crowd, make proper eye contact, and use appropriate hand gestures. And you should assiduously strive to use the word of the day. This is a timed exercise, as the light will turn green, which is the same color as the Great Gazoo, at 1 minute, meaning that you will qualify. At 1.5 minutes, the light will turn yellow, which is the same color as Barney Rubble's hair. And at 2 minutes, the light will turn red, which is the same color as Wilma Flintstone's hair, as well as the hair of her daughter, mother-in-law. You'll have a 30 second grace period? 30 second grace period. And if you're not complete, if you did not complete your answer by then you will go extinct. For the first question, and speaking of the Great Gazoo, he was that little alien who floated around and only Fred and Barney could see him as he got Fred and Barney into a series of weird, wild, and wacky adventures. Now, my question for one of you is, tell us about that crazy cool friend that you had at some point in your life, or maybe you still do, who has just rocked your world. Haley Bota. Tell us about that crazy cool friend of yours.
Okay. Well, growing up in South Jersey, I always prided myself on being the good girl. I never experimented with drugs, I never smoked, and even to this day, I never drank. However, I had a badass friend named Michelle Yorgo. Michelle Yorgo introduced me to things that I'm not proud of today. However, I did partake. And that was shoplifting. Yes. My parents could afford to buy me things. However, there was nothing like the thrill of getting on my bike and biking with Michelle Yorgo down to the local drugstore and picking out our favorite color nail polishes and lipsticks, and lo and behold, just slipping them in our pocket, only to taunt the owner, Marty, who owned the drugstore, by saying, "Nice to see you, maybe we'll buy something tomorrow," and giggling the whole way home. There was something about this rush of being with Michelle Yorgo. And this went on from the age of 13 to about 17. But then I realized that this could really have a profound effect on my life, because Michelle got arrested, started to do drugs, and wound up in AA at a very young age. So unfortunately, I had to sever ties with her, but looking back, I have to say it was the most fun I ever had in my entire life hanging out with this delinquent.